Hey everyone, welcome back to the SwiftUI Series. Today we're diving into HealthKit, Apple's framework for accessing health data like steps, heart rate, calorie burned, and more. HealthKit is at the core of fitness apps, workout trackers, and wellness dashboards. And today I'll show you how to request user permission and access HealthKit data. So let's go ahead and dive on in. Something you can do when you're working in the simulator. So let's say we wanted to add the amount of steps to show the users. You can go up here to the top right and add data. So in this case, we can change the date, the time, and we can add steps. So let's say I want 20,000 steps. We can even go ahead and add this across multiple dates. So let's say hypothetically on the 4th here, we added, 15,000 steps or something like this, right? We can actually add this data in the simulator health kit to kind of mock how it might look for a real phone. You can do this with any of the health data. You can go to where it says pinned here and you can hit edit. And let's go ahead and add maybe our, physical effort. Go ahead and pin it. We can click on it and we can add the data. Alrighty, let's go ahead and hop on into Xcode. I'm gonna just call this one HealthKit example. We don't need the testing or storage. We're just gonna make sure we run a SwiftUI Swift app. Let me go ahead and get started here. So what is HealthKit? Well, it's Apple's secure framework that allows apps to read and write health-related data stored in the health app. What can we access? We can access step counts, heart rate, calories burned, and workout sessions. Just as a note, any app using HealthKit must get user permission, ensuring privacy and security. Let's go ahead and set up our project. So in our project settings on the top left here, we need to go to the signing and capabilities tab. And we can see here we have the capability at the very top left. And let's go ahead and look for HealthKit. So we'll need to add this to our app. We can hit return here and we can see that there's clinical health records and HealthKit background delivery. All right, let's go ahead and check that second one. If you do want the first one, you can enable both, although we shouldn't need that first one for our purposes today. Next, let's go ahead and right click and create a new empty file. And let's call this one HealthStore. I'm just gonna move this down to our preview content here. Alrighty, so what we need to do is we need to import HealthKit. That's the first step right away. And we're going to actually make a class that's going to manage the permissions and data retrieval. So let's go ahead and call it HealthStore. And we have a few things that we need to do. The first is we need to create a constant of HealthStore. So let HealthStore equals, and we're going to reference the HK, so HealthKit, HealthStore. So this is implemented by subclasses to initiate a new object, the receiver, immediately after the memory for it has been allocated. And we're going to now request permissions. So we're going to create a new function and we'll call it request authorization. Oh my goodness, how do you spell authorization? Authorization? Sounds right. Let's add our bracket and we'll say completion. And we're going to at escaping the lowercase e and another bracket bool comma error question mark, and then that would return, so we'll do the dash void. All right, let's go ahead and add our brace here. So let's first tackle the step count. So say let step count type equals hk quantity type, so with a capital Q, quantity type. We can do dot lowercase quantity type for identifier. And this is where we're going to grab the dot step count. And let's go ahead and add our exclamation point there. Next, let's grab the heart rate. So let heart rate type equals HK quantity type. Once again, dot quantity type for identifier dot rate. Add our exclamation points once again. And let's do calorie type. And you guessed it, we're going to be doing HK quality type dot quality type for identifier. What do you think this one is? If you had to guess, it's actually active energy burned, surprisingly enough. So if we do dot, we can actually see everything here. But for the calories, we would be doing the active energy burned. But we can see we have a lot of different things. We have Apple exercise time, we have stand time, right? Blood pressure, cycling power, you can kind of scroll through these and you can see all of the data offered to us by HealthKit. Even if someone's put in their height, you can grab their height there as long as you've gotten the permission from the user. So any data that you're going to be using, you need to properly request that for the user. Anyways, the active energy burned is the 1-4 calories. And let's go down here and say types to read. We're going to set capital S equals, we'll add our array here, and we're going to add the step count type, heart rate type, and calorie type. I have my autofill kind of coming in clutch here. I'm just going to fill that in. We'll do health store dot request authorization to share. And this is where we can include an array of things that we're going to share. In this case, we're going to just keep it blank. And for the reads, we're going to reference that types to read we just created above. We'll then add a brace. So we'll say success, not error, in, just in, not integer, get out of here. And then we'll have our completion, success, comma, error. So this ensures that the user grants permission before our app can access HealthKit data. Now let's fetch real-time health stats. So now that we have the authorization, let's go ahead and go under this function, or you can go above. But for my cases, purposes, I'm just going to put it underneath. And we're going to create something that's going to fetch the step count data from HealthKit. So even if you want to add a comment here, fetch step count data from HealthKit. Go ahead and create a function. We'll call it fetch step. We'll add a parameter of completion, just like we had above at escaping. In this case, it'll be a double, and then we will return void. We can add a brace here. So what we can do is we can add the step type, we can add the start date, and we can add the predicate. So the first one, let's do the step type. So let step type equals HK. Quantity type, probably already know what we're doing here, dot quantity type for identifier, and we're going to be doing dot step count, letter exclamation point there, and we'll do let start date equals calendar dot current dot start of day 4. Let's reference date with a capital D, so this is going to be for today's date, and let predicate equals HK query dot predicate for samples. We're going to be doing a camel case there, and we'll do with start and end. So this first thing here, actually, you know what? Let's include some options as well. I'm going to do the second one. So predicates for samples with start and options. So under the date here, we're going to reference that start date we have just created above. On the end, we can just reference date with a capital D. And under the options, we have some options, and we're going to do the strict start date. So the sample start time must fall within the target time period. All right, cool. Next, we're going to create our query. So we'll say let query. Wow, the autofill is like, I got you, homie. But we're going to type everything out here so we can kind of make sure that you can follow along if you're not looking at it visually. All right, we're going to say HK static query. So statics, multiple query. We'll add a bracket here and we'll say quantity type. And this is where we're going to include the step type, comma, quantity sample predicate, and that's going to reference that predicate we created above, comma, options, and we'll do dot cumulative sum. So this is an option indicating that the system calculates the sum of all quantities for the sample. All right, after that, we are going to add a brace, and we're going to say underscore, comma, space, result, underscore, in. All right, we're going to do the next line, and we're going to say let step count equals result question mark dot sum quantity. We're going to leave that empty. We're going to add a question mark after dot double value 4. And we're going to reference this as the dot count empty brackets. And then we're going to use our double question mark for the fallback there. And we're going to put 0. Next, we'll add a dispatch queue. So dispatch queue dot main.async. Now we'll add some code here, and we're just going to add our completion and our step count. All right, and then at the very, very end of this query, so we're going to go down two braces. We're going to say HealthStore dot execute, and then we're going to put in our query that we created right here on line 39. So this fetches the user step count for today and updates the UI in real time. Now, if you didn't want to do step count, if you want to do calories, right, you would basically recreate this for whatever data you're trying to update or show in real time. So let's hop on over to our content view, and we're going to be using this to display the user step count in a SwiftUI view. Now, this is something you can also test on your phone if you really want to walk around and see those like steps kind of popping up. But like I showed you before, we can actually use the simulator to see those steps. All right, let's go ahead and get rid of our placeholders. I'm actually going to keep the VStack. Let's go ahead and add some text, and we'll say today's steps. I think that's supposed to have the apostrophe here. We can add some font. Let's do title. Do whatever you want, really. Next, we're going to display that step count. Let's go under our structure here, and we'll create a state private variable. So at state private var step count, which will be a double, and let's by default have it equals 0. Then we're going to say let health store equals health store with an empty bracket. So that's going to reference that class that we've made above here in our health store Swift file. Well, I called it HealthStore. I don't know why I'm so bad at spelling health. I think I'm like misspelled it like 20 times already. What was the other one I was doing? When it was habits, I tried to do it with two B's, like as in a rabbit. Okay, let's add some more text here, and let's go ahead and interpolate that step counter. We're actually going to convert it to be an integer. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a string, forward slash int. We're going to add another bracket. We're going to put in the step count. Yeah, we can also customize this. Let's go ahead and just make it bold. And maybe we'll make it really stand out with maybe large title. Okay, then we'll add a button here, and we'll call it fetch steps. And we'll do healthstore.fetchStepCount. And then here we'll do healthstore.fetchStepCount. Gonna add my brace here, and we'll say steps in, and then we'll say step count equals steps. We can also add some button styling, button style. I'm a big fan of that bold root prominent. We can add some tint as well. Let's do brown. I haven't done a brown button in a while. All right, something else we have to do is we have to request information. So let's go to our info.plist. Let's go ahead and add a kind of property here. We'll do privacy, and we want to look for the HealthKit share usage description. So the app needs to share with heart rate and other stats, right? Whatever we want to kind of tell the user there. So if we were to launch this app or even use this app right now, where we're trying to fetch the steps, we'll notice that nothing's happening. This is because we need to still grab that permission from the user. So we've added our privacy here, right? When the app needs to share, but let's go back to our content view. And after the padding, we'll add a dot on up here. We're gonna add a brace here. We're going to reference a function that hasn't been added yet. We're gonna call it request health kit. Access. Okay, now all the way down here, right before our last brace, before the preview and all that, we're going to create a function, and it's going to be that request kit access. We'll add our brace here, and this is going to request HealthKit authorization on app launch, or essentially when this content view pops up. So we're going to say healthstore.requestAuthorization. We actually don't need those brackets whatsoever. Instead, we're going to add a brace. We'll say success, comma, error, in. And you can see on our preview here, it's actually popping up. That might pop up quite a bit. But let's go ahead and say if let error equals error. This way we can actually track if something goes wrong. We can figure out what's happening. We will print healthkit auth failed, and we can actually interpolate that error. localized description, right? We should be good to go, but it's a good idea to kind of think about these use cases. And let's add an else statement, right? Error handling is very important. Let's print HealthKit auth was successful. Okay, so now we can see that we can choose what we want to share. Let's go ahead and share all those things. We'll hit allow, but it doesn't update on the preview properly. Let's go ahead and pop it open in the simulator real quick, and hopefully we can grab those steps now. Alrighty, and we can see that we have our steps. When we press the button, it's like, oh, hey, look at that. Let's go ahead and also just do turn on, I'll turn on. Off all allow, go ahead and fetch those steps, and yay, these steps are being displayed. So I know I showed it at the start of the video, but let's go to home and we can go to health. And here is where you can edit these different things. So if we click on these steps here, we can add that data, right, for different days. If we add more for February 3rd, let's add a whole bunch more steps. Let's go ahead and go back to our HealthKit example. And we can see that those steps have been fetched and are updating. Now, you don't have to do this through a button. Maybe you have every 30 seconds you can update the steps or something like that, but this is just a way to show you how to get that data. So now our SwiftUI view fetches and displays step count data dynamically. If we were to use this on a real phone, we could walk around and press the button and, you know, it would update the steps as we're moving and grooving. So this is just an example. If you want to display things like heart rate, if you want to display any of the health stats, you just need to ask for permission for the user. Something you'll also notice is when we were grabbing that permission, we were asking for these three different stats. If you want to grab anything else from the user, in your health store or whatever else you're kind of calling this switch file, that class, you'll need to create those let statements and then tell the HealthKit what you're trying to grab, right? In the case of the step count, we can change this to be a lot of different things. You can kind of scroll through these, even like cycling speed, right? A lot of them should have a good description, or they're kind of just descriptive enough. So let's change this back to step count. So if we had a whole bunch here and we requested permission from the user, we would be able to see a lot of those different things that people can opt into. So if you want to experiment on your own grabbing the heart rate or even the calories, feel free to do so and experiment. We've already kind of set you up a little bit for success there. You'll just need to go into your health store here, and where we've done the function of fetching step count, you'll have to take similar precautions for the heart rate or the calories, right? For every one of those, you'll want to create its own function. So for the final takeaways here, now that you've learned the HealthKit basics, here's how you can use these skills in real world apps. So a fitness and workout app, track daily steps, running distance and workout intensity, diet and calorie trackers, medical and heart health apps, monitor heart rate and trends over time. Maybe you want to create a personal wellness app, let users set those health goals and track progress. So now it's your turn. Try adding more HealthKit features and build your own fitness app or health app, whatever you want to do with this data. Or maybe you can even use that data with a chart kit video we made last time. If you enjoyed this, like and subscribe for more SwiftUI tutorials. See you in the next one. Dream big and code bigger.